Goedemorgen.
Iedereen. Welcome everyone to the Global Scale Up Program, the Life Sciences and Health Mission that we are organizing this year. Completely different, digital, completely new experience. And we are honored and we are very happy to be here in San Francisco at the Consulate of the Netherlands in San Francisco. I'm here with the Consul General, Dirk Jansen. Dirk, thank you so much for having us here.
It's a pleasure. Thank you, Marianne. Welcome to San Francisco, everybody. It's a pleasure for us at the Consulate to receive you here over the coming days, albeit virtually, with the exception of Marianne, unfortunately. It's of course a pity that you cannot be with us here in person, but it also has some serious advantages. For instance, you don't have a jet lag right now, and we will fly you from San Francisco to Irvine, to LA, to Phoenix, while you're sitting in your chair at home. So I would say, fasten your seatbelts, put your chair in the upright position, and let's go. A few words to introduce our consulate. We are based in San Francisco, but we represent our country in the 13 westernmost states of the United States. So those are 13 states from Alaska to Hawaii, although we focus mainly on California, on Arizona, Colorado, Oregon, and Washington state. Our consulate used to be in LA, but we moved to San Francisco about 10 years ago, basically to be closer to Silicon Valley, given its enormous economic significance. Since the pandemic started, we have gone completely digital, and our ambition as a consulate is to really be at the forefront when it comes to digital diplomacy. As we are the consulate in the most innovative region in the world, we aim to be an example and an inspiration for other Dutch embassies and consulates in that regard. So we see the pandemic as an opportunity to broaden the scope of our services, of our activities, and also an opportunity to broaden our client base, our public. For instance, last Friday, we had a lecture by Ben Feringa, the Nobel laureate from the University of Groningen. And we would have done that at the consulate originally, where we can host maybe 60, 70 people max. And now we did it online and we had 1,400 unique visitors. So every crisis is also an opportunity. This is our third digital trade mission for our consulate. So we hope that with the lessons learned from the earlier missions, we can offer you an interesting and useful program in the coming days, but we do welcome your feedback. So if there's any suggestions, if you have any comments or ideas, please do let us know because we are also here to learn. Now let's zoom in a little bit on startups. Our main instrument to help startups and scale-ups is what we call Holland in the Valley. And Holland in the Valley is basically the Dutch ecosystem in Silicon Valley. It's an initiative of our consulate and several Dutch and American corporate and academic partners. And the goal is to strengthen the network of Dutch entrepreneurs, venture capitalists, researchers, etc. in Silicon Valley, and to provide an infrastructure for them to help startups and scale-ups from the Netherlands. That's the idea. And these successful Dutchies in Silicon Valley, they serve as mentors for startups. They can introduce startups in their network. They help us to develop training programs for startups, et cetera, et cetera. That's Holland in the Valley in a very small nutshell. And I think that for Holland in the Valley, it's crucial to partner with programs such as the Global Scale-Up Program, because at the end of the day, you know, we aim for the same goal. And that is to help startups to be successful in the US, successful in entering the US markets, successful in obtaining venture capital, or both. So we are very happy to work with you. And it's great fun, and certainly also for us a privilege to work with such promising startups over the next few days and beyond, hopefully, because this should only be the beginning of your American adventure. And we are very proud of our innovative and diverse life sciences and health startups and scale-ups in the Netherlands. And that diversity, I've seen it will be on full display here this week. The 14 of your companies are active in medical tech, biotech, pharma, digital health. And these areas are, I would say, now more than ever during these difficult times at the forefront of innovation and digital transformation. So we see many opportunities for Dutch startups and scale-ups in the US to, let's say, streamline and overcome the obstacles of this day and age. And we hope, we really hope that this week will help you in scaling your business. Because of these opportunities, our consulate is prioritizing life sciences and health for 2021. And we are looking for collaborations on the West Coast, working together closely with our Netherlands Business Support Office in LA and our great honorary consuls in San Diego and Phoenix. And they are also heavily involved in this program. So I think we are ready for takeoff. On behalf of the whole team here at the consulate, I wish you a very fruitful and exciting mission. And I'm handing back to you, Marianne.
Yes, that's great. And I really like what you're saying, Dirk. A crisis can also be an opportunity. And you are showing it here at the consulate. But I think that's also, you know, advice for you guys and for all of us. This crisis can be an opportunity. And we are all here to scale up the companies, at least to figure out how and in what way you can do it. And that's why we would like to start with a short conversation with two CEOs who already took the step to come to the United States. So that's Arjen van Malen from Skyline DX and Noel van Mortel from Access to Bone. So Arjen, do you want to say a few words about your company?
Thanks, Marianne, and great to have us and to be provided the opportunity. So Skyline DX is a company based in the Netherlands that has a lab in San Diego as well. And we partner with academics to really develop molecular diagnostics that will facilitate precision medicine. So to really get tailored treatments for patients.
And Noel, your company.
So we're Access to Bone. We're in the market of orthopedics. And for the patients that need to heal a bone defect, we developed a stimulus, and we are about to market that stimulus. And we tend to do that. We want to do that from our subsidiary in Los Angeles.
Okay, so that's probably interesting, Dirk, to ask them a couple of questions because you've done it, and you know.
Absolutely, I'm very impressed by both of your companies, and you're an example, I think, also of already being in the United States and doing well here. My first question would be, why for your companies, the US market, or more specifically the West Coast of the US, is an interesting place, an interesting market?
Well, shall I start?
Yes, sure.
Yes, please.
Well, we're in the market of donor bone tissue products, and Europe is lagging far, far behind in that field. And we, as a company, we need to be where the infrastructure is, and in terms of suppliers, labs, personnel, and regulatory folks. And that's the West Coast of the United States. So that's why we're based in the West Coast. The second reason is we're based at UCI, and their startup facility is second to none. So we were able to build our development lab and our facility at their startup facility.
Yes, and it is great at UCI. Yeah, well, I'm a bit prejudiced, but Arjen, what is it for you?
Yeah, so we're in the business of developing to commercial stage molecular diagnostics. And when it comes to molecular diagnostics, California is the place to be in the U.S. So it really is the hub where you see a lot of the startups, but also the more established companies located there specifically.
Right. And what would be your key advice for other companies? Because you took the step, and what is it, Noel?
Well, I think having a subsidiary is key. A US-based competitor that we know really well, he calls Nienke and Mike a scary pool of talent. And to leverage that talent, we really needed to be in the US. We couldn't do that from the Netherlands. As a matter of fact, when we were raising capital, companies insisted and VCs insisted that we would have a subsidiary in the States.
Yes, I recognize what you're saying, Noel. It seems like a scary step, right? Because you don't know exactly what's going to happen and if everything is going to be successful. But taking that step of getting a subsidiary is important. Arjen, what is your advice?
That's a bit in the line of what Noel said. So I would really echo that, where I would say that we went through a steep learning curve. The salaries are a bit different in the US compared to what we would recognize in Europe. And for us, the learning curve would be that you need to hire smart and also be able to time it according to what you're able to do as a business. So we started too early with commercialization, and in retrospect, we would have done that differently. And we probably would have been more successful if we would be able to define leadership positions in an early start.
Right, Arjen, I recognize also what you are saying, that salaries and costs are way higher than in Europe. So sometimes we're hesitant, as companies. It's like, and you don't know the people yet, so who are you hiring? That remains a very important question. Dirk, do you have a final question?
Yes, the final question would be what we can do as a consulate to support you, not only during these days, during this mission, but also in the weeks and months, maybe even years to come, to help you to be successful here on the West Coast. Noel.
Well, I'm looking at short future and for the rest of next year. And I would say a shortcut to contacts and warm introductions. Certainly in this time when there are no trade shows and when travel to the US is really, really hard. We can't visit as we used to do. So yeah, we would really appreciate your help in that field.
Great, thank you. Arjen?
I would say for us the same. So really to navigate, there are a lot of consultants, a lot of companies, a lot of small and bigger companies that offer their services, to navigate to the right people, the right companies, and also being able to qualify or help qualify these will be really beneficial for our business.
Yeah, Arjen, I completely recognize what you are saying. And I think that's why our collaboration and with the consulate, Holland in the Valley, trying to build that network in combination for life sciences company, global scale up, really in depth, knowing the people in the network very close by, because we are here, is an absolute strong combination, because it remains important who you are dealing with. And sometimes people say they can do everything and you have to know them. So yeah, that's I think some good advice for all of us. I would like to to close this session. Maybe Dirk, you have a final word?
Yeah, I just want to wish everybody good luck over the coming days, and a special thank you to you, Marianne. It's great to be working with you, to the partners, to the government agency, GPAC and AZ Commerce, who we will see later on in the program. MentorGem, the company that provided our fantastic digital platform. Also, thank you. And of course, the whole GSP team for organizing this week. It's great to be working with you. Thank you very much. And I wish you all lots of success.
Thank you, Dirk. Right.